Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Best in Slot. Welcome back to Planet Zoo. Welcome back to Elderwood Zoo in particular, as we begin our journey into the brand new Twilight Pack. We're starting a new mini part of Elderwood today where we will be including all five animals eventually. I have fairly elaborate plans for what's coming. I'm not going to spoil them. I'm going to not attempt to tell you everything I've got in mind, just in case. But we are building something. We're building part one today. And the idea is to build something I've really wanted to do for a long time. We kind of tried it with the North American Zoo, but frankly, I wasn't good enough. I didn't know what I was doing enough to pull it off at the time. And one thing I really wanted to do was build a real functioning looking little North American town, Halloween town. Kind of like if you watch Trick or Treat, my favorite horror film, very, very appropriate for the season. And, you know, people put pumpkins everywhere and they put decorations everywhere and it's all lit up and nice and it's kind of got this wholesome Halloween kind of feeling. I will, of course, be flipping that on its head very shortly, but for today's video, we've got this nice little wholesome Halloween town. So, what you're watching is about a 4.5 hour build. However, I built 6 houses, just in another zoo before even doing this. So they're already done. It's kind of like with Amsterdam, where I thought if I went and built them ahead of time and kind of just chilled and kind of did that before I tried to record the actual time lapse, then I'd get a lot more done. And it proved to be very, very helpful rather than trying to cram everything into one video. And it just means I can duplicate them and I've got the blueprints, yada, yada, yada. They're nothing special, they're just little small town houses. So, people did suggest I shouldn't put this in Elderwood. I wanted to for 2 reasons. One, I love Elderwood, I don't love the other zoo. Two, I think it still works. So Elderwood, of course, meant to be a national park, but it's always meant to be a little bit of a town as well. And we were going to have a town down by the docks. But the problem with that one was it was going to be a bit of a businessy, not business, but like a worker's village almost. You know, it's where all the dock workers live, it's where all the fishermen live, yada, yada, yada. It wasn't going to be a very small town, cute America kind of thing, which is something I always really wanted to build. So this is the town of Lusmore, or the village, I suppose, which is the Irish words for foxglove. And you will notice during this video, there are no foxgloves in this video. It's very much a hint for the future. So we're just gonna build this little cute Halloween village and we're gonna have raccoons running all around it because that's what raccoons would do. One of the good things about this pack is you can very much integrate these animals into a fairly standard looking setting and things kind of make sense, right? So just building a little entranceway here. I am using, not right now, but for a lot of this, we're going to be using a lot of the other things we've already used in Elderwood. There's still going to be some redwood trees, still going to be some grass, largely the same foliage. I'm bringing in some of the new pack foliage and these orange sort of autumnal trees because I really want to use the autumnal ground covering. I really want everything to be orange. I want it to feel like you just tipped pumpkin spice lattes over the entire place, basically. That's very much the vibe that I was going for. That kind of autumnal, sweet Halloween combination. So, didn't really have a great plan for this, but the idea was very much to have a main street where you'll walk down, but I didn't want it to just have one main street because I think that looks a little bit fake, so I wanted at least 3 streets. The idea being that you'd only be able to walk down this one. I'm going to block the guests off from the others by using the barriers and sinking them into the ground, but I think it's important to have multiple streets because that way at least it looks more like a functioning real town, and it's meant to be. This is meant to feel like an actual town in Elderwood. And I think by using the right materials, by using the right trees, yada, 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 it does still feel correct. I think it still feels part of it. Some new foliage, of course, but we've been doing that for the whole series anyway. We've been bringing in new types of foliage to make each individual section feel a little bit unique. And yeah, things are going to get a little bit crazy. Not going to pretend otherwise. But I do have an in-world justification for everything that I'm going to do, as you will see, because Elderwood has been a fairly low-key, semi-realistic kind of place so far, and I do want to keep that vibe, so I do have a plan on how to retain that, as you shall see in future videos. But yeah, I really want to carry on working on Elderwood. It was never, you know, it might just be the zoo that we come back to every time there's a new update. I do have another idea of something I want to do with other things as well, yada yada. Here, realizing that these buildings were just a little bit too far apart. Need some space between them. I want to build like a yard and stuff like that. At this point, the whole thing just looks super, super ugly, as you can tell. And I had to convince myself. I remember literally saying to myself, if I just keep working on it, it will look cool later on. If I keep working on it, it'll look cool later on. Because for a long time, a really long time, Oh, these are the guest barriers. If you just sink these under the ground, guests won't walk past there anyway. Here I'm using the same buildings again, but as you can see, I'm just going in and changing some of the wall colours and stuff like that. It's a very small change, it's not a big deal or anything, but it makes the buildings feel demonstrably different, and that way you can kind of get away with using the same buildings, like we did with Amsterdam, of course. Yeah, I just had to keep saying myself. If I just keep going, I had like a really strong image in mind. I knew exactly what I wanted to make, and I just had to trust that if I kept sticking things in, something good would happen eventually. So yeah, one of the benefits of this, I mean, it does feel a little different from the rest of Elderwood, but it's very much secluded in a lot of ways from the rest of Elderwood. You know, this bit kind of sticks out a little bit, but this is just a nice wholesome town, that's fine. You could get this in this kind of environment. This is Ohio, sort of themed, because it's trick-or-treat, trick-or-treat set in Ohio. It's also going to have a little bit of Last House on the Left in there. The Descent will be featuring in the future. I've got a few horror films I'm going to be integrating, because of course I bloody am. It's the Twilight pack, I'm very excited. The decorations are awesome. I do wish we had more of them. I felt that quite a lot during this video, but they are very cool. But yeah, so this is when it started to feel a little bit better. So I'm just going to start lining the streets with these, what are these again? The sugar maple trees. They've just got this lovely autumnal, I said autumnal far too many times already, but they've got this lovely autumnal kind of vibe to them. I'm just sticking those in plant pots just so they look a little bit more realistic. And this is really the first part of how I'm going to sell the vibe I'm going for, not the vents. They're meant to be like gutter drain sort of things. This bit here, just putting down the fallen leaves all over the ground. The problem with these leaves, and it'd be lovely to see it changed, is that you can't change the colour. So you can only use them basically for the sugar maple tree. There's like a couple of orangish trees, but this is really the only one in the entire game that feels like correct basically to use. The others are close, but no cigar. So it really limits you. And we could have like really cool leaf litter for just like a general green one, for example, or like a dead brown one as well would be really cool. A little bit more variety. As it happens, you know, these are perfect for what I wanted anyway, but I know that other people would like to see a little bit more variety. Here, just dotting the trees around, dotting the leaves around. This is sort of a road where you would be able to have cars come down, but it's meant to be a very small, sleepy village and people aren't necessarily driving around all over the place kind of thing. Lots and lots of leaves, lots and lots of foliage. Tried to keep it more at the edges and places where I thought the leaves would naturally gather, where they get blown in by the wind or by the rain, yada, yada, yada. And yeah, the hardest part of this really, because it's kind of built into a little valley and I don't want it to feel necessarily like it is. So you just kind of got to use a lot of trees and kind of obscure things in a little bit and kind of seclude it without necessarily feeling like that's the end. A little bit of bush here any second now. Love a good bush. Where's my bush? There it is. Using the new yew trees, actually. They make for really effective bushy foliage sort of things. And I was looking at an image of Trick or Treat. They go to pick up, you don't see Trick or Treat by the way, go watch Trick or Treat right now. Stop watching this and go watch Trick or Treat. They go to pick up the little witchy girl as part of one of the stories. And I'm looking at her, I'm looking at her right now, and her house covered in jack-o'-lanterns, absolutely covered. The purple house on the left is actually based directly on her house in Trick or Treat, and one of the other houses is based on where the old guy lives, Crowley? I don't remember. But to the side of our house is like a little alleyway section, but it's covered in foliage, and I don't know, I remember just in my creepy little suburb, there was always little alleyways that were just basically just filled with bushes and stuff like that. So this did a lot of work to making the houses feel better, is adding the fences and then adding mulch over the top of the concrete. I wanted it to have, again, like for it to feel, that's the house by the way, the little witch girl. Again, I wanted to feel like a real town, so they all had to be raised up on the concrete, there had to be like a pavement sort of thing, they had to have a garden, yada yada yada. You'll notice as I'm doing this, I'm putting a lot more work on the central houses, and I'm not worried about, say, the fences at the back of the house and stuff like that, because you're not going to see it at the end of the day. You're never going to see it as a guest in the zoo, and that's really all that matters to me. I kind of, I think I've talked and used this exact metaphor before, but, not metaphor, but example, it's kind of like when you're painting, and let's say you've got a character who's face forward, you'll put a lot of detail into the face and like a little bit less detail into the upper torso, and then as you get lower down the body, you put less and less work in because you want to draw the eye in the important direction. And also there's just no point in having everything 100% detailed when that's not the important bit. It's the same kind of principle with zoo design, I think. counts more when you're doing daft stuff like this rather than people out there. I've seen so many people doing proper normal zoo designs. I'm like, yeah, I had to go back to what I do, don't I? Elderwood will still continue with its relatively normal stuff as well. This pack is just super themed, and I think everyone watching me knew I was going to go hard on this one because it's just kind of my kind of thing, right? The Twilight pack, a horror themed pack. So. I have slight concerns I've got COVID. I need to find a test, but I've been sick for about 6 days now, so it's wearing me down. Headache, cough, tasteless a little bit as well, so yeah, I'm a little concerned about that, considering I've got a Halloween party this weekend, so we'll see what happens. But yeah, just chucking all the mulch in here. I'm going to cover all this in foliage and grass and stuff later on. But you'll see, I'm kind of doing the side houses, but I'm less worried about it being super neat. You're kind of going to spot it from a very, very slight distance, but you're not really going to see if the mulch is a little bit out of line, or if the fence is a little bit out of line, yada, yada, yada. It's just so that when you see it from a distance, it does look like some care has been put into it, even if in reality it's been fairly lackluster. I don't know why I thought about this. I've got two buildings there. I've got a trade center and I've got a staff room, I think, or a keeper hut or something like that. But of course, this whole thing is going to be an exhibit. It lags like crazy, by the way. There's so much for them to climb on, the raccoons, that when I turn on the heat map to try to find places they can escape, it lags the hell out of my game. It's pretty crazy. It's kind of annoying, actually. You have to do something about that. At the moment, they can escape absolutely everywhere. I'm not too worried about it right now because I've got another place to build. I'm not doing any spoilers for the future of this series. I'm just gonna get it done. But I've got plans, a little bit more plans for the village, as you'll see in the next video. And when that's done, then the whole thing will hopefully be tight. I guess not the word I want. Waterproof? What, like raccoon proof, as in they're not going to escape. Anyways, putting some Halloween themed black and orange bunting down the middle, stick some lights on there. I really wanted the whole thing to be, it's probably not still there as much as I want. I wanted it to be quite bright. I wanted it to feel like Trick or Treat is. It's Trick or Treat, by the way. I really recommend it. It's kind of like a celebration of Halloween. It's a love letter to Halloween. It's not about being spooky per se. I mean, the film does try to be spooky at several points, but it's about celebrating the holiday. Here I'm just going around and adding some bits to each garden, just a little fountain here and there, a little bicycle, just anything to make each individual house feel a little bit unique and a little bit special. I wasn't really putting too much thought in it, just sort of stuff in the garden over the foliage. I really wanted, again, for it to feel like a real town in a lot of ways, you know? Real small town Ohio. Where I realise a lot of the buildings are very similar in some ways, in that most of them are raised on like a little bit of stone, a little staircase in front of the door, they've got like a little porch overhang thing, tends to be a steeple one where it's like pointing upwards. What, square rectangular windows, and then sort of curved ones in the upper reaches. Yada yada yada. A little bit of detail work on the road. I was really unsure whether to do this or not because it feels a little bit drivey, but I felt like the road needed something to just break it up a little bit, and at the end of the day it looks fine. It's not really a big concern. I think it really helps, actually. Oh god, it's so cute. Still not even done the decoration yet. I was building up to that. That was the last thing I was going to do, so I had to make sure I earned it by doing all the busy work in the meantime. So just going around here and adding different types of foliage to each garden. Again, I wanted each garden to feel a little bit unique. It's not the primary focus, but they should feel individual, at least to some extent. And that means a lot of Yorkshire Foggrass, as per usual. God, I love Yorkshire Foggrass. Again, this is what I mean. I'm still using, you'll see I've got the heart ticked. I'm still using all the foliage I've been using throughout Elderwood. There's a couple extra new things in there, but I'm hoping that by consistently using those same pieces of foliage, you know, you can see all the redwoods around this. There's new redwoods, by the way. I don't know if I'm going to use them, because we already have redwoods, but there are new redwoods, California ones. But I was hoping that by consistently using some of the foliage we've used before, it will feel more like part of the same zoo, essentially. Obviously it's a little bit different, I'm not going to pretend otherwise, but get over it, basically. I'm happy with the choice, I think. Adding a little fence in here. Again, just wanting all the fences to feel different. There's a few white picket fences, there's a few iron fences, yada yada. Just trying to make sure each house has a little dash of its own personality. I really think this is something they need to change. Benches and bins and stuff like that, you just can't add them anywhere you want, and it's really annoying. Like, even if we had like a non-facility version, just like a building version, just like a free item that didn't work as a facility item, that would make me really happy. Because I can't put it anywhere. I just want to have a bench or a bin on my sidewalk, and I can't do it. Grumble, grumble, grumble. Anyways, decoration time. So this is the fungus house. Each house is going to have slightly different themes. This is a gargoyle house. This is the puppet house with the puppet in the window. Some bats on the front. This is the eye house and the decal house in general. Again, I feel like I needed more stuff. I might spend a little time making some more decorations. I wanted to put my ears in the skip. What can I say? This is the stalactite / bat house for some reason, you know? Just chucking in whatever I could think of, basically. And then, no house is the pumpkin house. Every house is the pumpkin house, basically. Just pumpkins, probably 500 pumpkins. There's pumpkins everywhere. Because again, if you watch Trick or Treat, there are pumpkins bloody everywhere. Including the Witchy Girl's house in particular, but people just stick tons of pumpkins around. I am looking at the images, and I think it maybe needs more lights, if anything. I'm hoping that when people come into the park, at the moment the park's shut, I'm hoping that if people were here, it would maybe get a new lease of life in that way, but we'll see. Put all the pumpkins down, and then you've got to put candles in the smaller ones and the medium-sized ones. In retrospect, I would have just saved an item that was a medium pumpkin with a candle inside it instead of doing this manually for absolutely all of them, but that's neither here nor there, and I bloody didn't. So get over it, society. Pumpkin, 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 pumpkin. And then some eyes in the trees. I just wanted to feel like this is a town. You know, again, Elderwood, as we've discussed, used to be an old mining town, which is actually super appropriate for what I'm going to be doing sooner. And they've been looking for ways to make more money for a long time. You know, the town's a little bit decrepit. It's been falling apart. But this little town, you know, they still, every Halloween, they put the work in and they become like a little bit of a tourist attraction every Halloween. Because people do this. People, whenever I Google for little Halloween towns for research for these series, and these are my old decorations from the North American park. And in retrospect, they are terrible, but I'm using them anyway. There's always articles about, you know, best little towns to visit for Halloween and stuff like that. Well, this town is one of those towns. That's the idea, you know, it's one of those little towns that you'd come and visit and spend Halloween at. And for Elderwood, which is personified by its natural beauty and also by its desperate capitalism grabbing, well, it kind of works perfectly. So, raccoons coming in, just adding in a bandit. You can see the exhibit is gigantic and there's tons of stuff for them to climb on, which I think is the problem. I did add, as I say, a couple of the staff buildings, but of course they're inside the habitat, which means they don't work, which is a bit of a shame. I think that'd be quite a cool thing if you could have staff buildings work on the interior of a habitat and not necessarily need a staff gate, because it would have been perfect for things like this. I get that technically that doesn't make too much sense, but that doesn't matter, leave me alone. So I just had to add a little side section near the bridge. That far right corner at the moment has some brachiation metal things. Here I was just trying to stop them all bloody escaping and lagging like a madman. I think I might turn it into a car park or something. I'm not quite sure. I might have a look at Trick or Treat, see if I can find something that resonates with me. I could build the lift from Trick or Treat. That might make me really happy, actually. I don't know. We'll see how I feel. The far end of the town hasn't been done yet, because in theory, and this is only a theory, the next video should be pretty easy. We'll see. I've got a slightly crazy idea. I had like a brainwave a few days ago when trying to plan this zoo out, and it just clicked. This weird idea clicked, and yeah, so you'll see next video, hopefully. Yeah, nearly done now. Just decided I need more pumpkins, clearly. stick those on the roof, dot them around everywhere. We're going to build a little sign, of course. It's still going to have, again, all those things from Elderwood. It's going to have the vertical animal signs, it's going to have the little information. Well, the fake information science, it must be said, but it's still going to have to be information science. Again, it is meant to feel like part of Elderwood, even if different at the same time, right? It's separate but equal, but not... You know what I mean, right? It's the same place, but it's not quite the same style. But it's somewhat the same style. I know what I mean. Anyways, I'll hop in game. I'll show you everything I did in a little bit more detail. I'll see you then at sick. Bye. Okay then, here we go. So this connects on with the sea of mank habitat we did towards the end of the last zoo, which I still really like this whole area over here. You're going to cross over the bridge, and things are going to just begin to get a little bit more autumnal. As I say, I do still want it to feel like Elderwood, and I think it does. There's a lot of redwoods here, and the grass is going to be the same. This area needs a little bit of love still. But this video is all happening a little bit late in the day. I did all of this today, so I'm a little bit pressed for time. So this will all get worked on. As for this section down here, but this is pretty cool that this now leads over to the bridge. So this is going to cross over. I'm going to put a path going all the way across there. So this will now lead into the town and probably a dead end. I might have it drop down here and curl around because there's tons of space over there. But if not, you can always cross over the railway bridge. Anywho, so let's check out the town itself. I know I still need to do the signs, but I say a bit pressed for time, but they will be up before the next video. This is going to say, welcome to Lusmore, which is, again, the name of the town. The Irish term for foxgloves. But that's going to be in like nice Elderwood style lettering, and then instead of Lusmore, it's going to have in graffiti bid at the end. Welcome to Lusmore bid, eh? Because it's Halloween, and it's, yeah? You appreciated it, didn't you? He loved it. Right, so let's go check out the town. We'll do it in daytime first, and then we'll come back at night as well. So here we go. My little, oh, it's actually so cute. My little Halloween town. That will, of course, say, I don't know what I was going to say, raccoon, ramble, how do I say village and raccoon? I guess it doesn't have to be the same letter. It never actually had to be. So yeah, there's all our little buildings. So the gargoyle one there, all the little pumpkins on the roof, and Myers checking you out, staring you down, little raccoon in the window. Got the signs up. I'm going to put a few more of these in, but I'll wait until I've done it. And like I said, so you can kind of see buildings at both sides. The village kind of carries on. We've got the fungi house over here. We've got this is the one based on the witch girl in Trick or Treat. This one's just general pumpkins and some farmy looking stuff and the decals over there. There's my little Sam that we made for the North American Zoo, crouching behind the haystack. Lots and lots of foliage on the corners, of course. I really like how the shadows work as well. That's really interesting looking. Got some decorations hung up on each of these things here. So the fox one, and just all the different ones on each different thing. Carry on walking. Little Halloween street. Over here with the witch's pots, because this is actually a staff building, as you can see. So it's got a path there, so I can add the cauldrons. Myers in the skip, because of course. My toxic waste, which I made last time. God knows why. And this one as well. I've used Myers quite a lot. And this one's just decals and bats and stalagmites and stuff like that. And of course, this bit needs a little bit of love. This will be, as I say, a car park or maybe something else. Not an animal exhibit. I've got all of those planned out. All five animals are planned out. Plus, as a bonus, an exhibit for the North American animals that I didn't include in the last pack. So that's the alligator. Or crocodile, I can't remember what it was now. Wasn't it an American alligator? So American alligator, I don't have an idea for that one yet, but I will do. The cougar has a plan already, stuff like that. But this is going to be a car park. I've put some buses in there or something so I can get guests into this area nice and easily maybe. Then again, this is part of a habitat, so I don't know how that would work. I might have to put a barrier up. We'll think about that. And then this will be the last house on the left. And I'm not going to give you any more detail about that. It isn't really based on the film, other than it being literally the last house on the left, but I just thought that was a cool thing we could chuck in as a reference. Let's make it nighttime. I'm not going to pretend this one is super about the animals themselves, it's kind of just something you experience as you walk around the town. I just thought that made sense for a raccoon, right? The vermin, essentially. So as you're walking through the town, you're going to see them now and again. And yeah, I think it's super cute, actually. I'm actually really happy with it. I feel like maybe the road is a little bit too big, or that I could maybe put some stalls in or something at the sides of the road, because I don't want it to feel like this is a road that you drive down. I do want it to feel like there would be tons of people walking down here, and this is path, so there would be people walking down here when the zoo was open, which I think will help. But I just feel like I can maybe have some things hanging down, some little food stalls at the sides, stuff like that maybe. Feel free to let me know down below in the comment section if you've got any ideas. Just little things I can do to populate this road area a little bit more. It should feel like it could be a road, but during Halloween time, when there's tons of tourists, it gets really popular and it's just people walking around. That's the kind of vibe I'm going for. But, yeah, this is an idea I've had for years. I've always wanted to build. I need to push those trees back, I think. I've always wanted to build, like, a Halloween town. With proper little houses and jack-o'-lanterns and everything. I've kept all the food items and the toys and stuff for the raccoons in the... I've stood up, I don't know how to sit back down. In the middle of the town in these buildings around here, because that obviously means they'll hopefully stay around in the appropriate area. But, yeah, I don't know. I really like it. It feels like... This one's a little bit haphazard, but it's kind of meant to be. It feels like small town Halloween, right? I hope. Justify me. oh god, I'm dying again. Down here it looks a little bit messier, but that's, you know, as I say, part and parcel of the plan. There is barriers right here, so you can only walk in a straight line down here until you get to the end. I just wanted it to feel like, if you look to the side, you know, the street carries on and there's other things going on. Not just your world kind of thing. It's meant to feel like an actual town, not an exhibit, is the idea. Maybe we need some lights over there, but yeah. Not much else to add to this one, folks. I'm pretty happy with it. Pretty happy how it came together. It's kind of done what I wanted it to do. It's yeah, I'm pretty pleased with it. It's got to be said. It's gonna get much dafter, but I think if you stick around with me for the next video, it's gonna be the fox habitat. If I can pull it off, the idea I've got, I think people are gonna really, really like it. I think it's really smart. I'm not trying to big myself up too much, but I think it's really smart. But anyways, there it is. And you can see from above, I think it fits in fine. Obviously, the colours are a little bit different, but they are over here as well. We've got those yellow trees over there. That one's a little bit more, but I think as this extends out as well. At the end of the day, the idea for Lusmore is to build down here. And then probably just put trees and mountain and stuff like that in front. It is going to get weirder. It is going to go to a point where it wouldn't realistically be in Elderwood. I do have in-world justification for how that happens, however. But I can obscure that bit from the public view, because it's going to be over here behind the last house on the left. And then, you know, all this bit over here can be exhibits and normal stuff that we'd already kind of built in that style. It's hard to get there, is my only concern. We might have to do a path down by the water. Or maybe just another route out of the town towards here at the back. Something like that, but I do need to get back over there. Maybe a monorail or something. Who knows? Either way, that is the start of our Halloween section for Elderwood. Hope you've enjoyed. I will do a little bit more work for the next video, just neatening things up. Maybe adding some, I think, food stalls and stuff is a good idea, if I can make that happen. Again, I just want a bit more of a party, light-hearted atmosphere kind of going on. And then things are going to get creepier in the next video. So I'll see you lovely folks there. Thank you very much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks very soon. Cheers much of as always. Oh, from your like if you enjoyed the video. Yeah. Cheers much of as always. Bye-bye. Nom.
Reaching out.